Hello everyone and welcome to my YouTube channel. So today we are going to learn the 5 reasons why you should be choosing Python. Now before we start, let me tell you, Python was introduced by Cbse in 2014, and during that time the teachers and the students were quite reluctant in accepting this programming language, and maybe that was a reason why it got discontinued a year ago. But now Python is back and Cbse has reintroduced it with certain changes in the syllabus. Now, I personally like this programming language a lot, and I do feel it is one of the perfect programming language for the beginners and for students. Now, let's go and check it out, the 5 reasons why you should be choosing Python. So the first point is, Python is extremely easy to learn. So to understand this point, we will take examples of other programming languages just to understand how Python makes things easy. So we will take an example of a C++ program for printing the message hello world onto the screen. So here is the code in front of you, that is #include_iostream.h, followed by the main function cout for printing the message and the return statement. And here is the output, that is hello world. Now any beginner who wants to start programming in C++ has to first understand certain basics, that is what is iostream.h, which is necessary to include, then followed by the main function and the cout and the return statement. So this is a basic C++ program for printing the message hello world. So we will put it aside. Now we will do the same program in Java with the same output. So here is the Java code in front of you with the same output. Now in Java, everything is included inside a class. Even the main function comes under a class. As a beginner, you have to first understand what a class is. You have to understand certain keywords like public and static. So this is a Java program, and now we will switch over to the Python program. So we will shift this also aside. So now we will see the same program in Python. And here is the code. Print hello world with the output. So if you see, there is only one line of code in Python. Now if you compare this with a C++ program or with Java, there are a few more lines of code to type. Top on that, in C++, you have to understand what is iostream.h, which is a header file. You have to understand the main function. And in Java, you have to understand what is a class. You have to understand the keywords like public or static. So compared to all this, Python is extremely easy to learn. Now as a beginner, it is pretty clear to you that this print statement will be printing a message. So it is extremely easy to understand a Python programming. So now we will move on to the next point. So the number 2 reason for you to choose Python is code less, produce more. Now let us understand this point with an example. So we will take an example in Python with a program for swapping 2 numbers. So this is a program where we are going to swap 2 numbers. So this is a code in front of you and the output. Now let us understand this code. The first line, that is a comma b is equal to 2 comma 4. Now in Python you can declare multiple variables with multiple values. For example, over here the value 2 is getting assigned to a and the value 4 is getting assigned to b. So the first value to the first variable, that is 2, is getting assigned to A, and the second value is getting assigned to the second variable, that is B. And then in the next line we are printing the values, that is A comma B. So you can see the output, we have 2 and 4. So because we are printing A first and then B, so 2 and 4. Now in third line we are actually swapping the numbers, that is A comma B is equal to B comma A. So the value of B, that is 4, is now getting assigned to the first variable, that is A, and the value of A, that is 2, is getting assigned to B. So this is how we swap numbers in Python. Now if you see the same program in C++ or in Java, you have to take a third variable or do some mathematical calculations for swapping 2 numbers. So in Python you have to do very less coding, but you can produce more results. In real life or in real world, in IT industries, there are some of the complex software that are developed in Python which produces the same output as compared to any other programming languages, or the software that are developed in other programming languages but in very less coding. So this way they can also save time. So this is one of the strongest feature of Python. Now we will see the third point, and the third point is Python is a purely object-oriented language, which is very important in today's time that any programming language should have this feature. So let us understand this feature with an example. So when we talk about object-oriented programming in Python, we actually talk about classes and object. Now in real world, everything is an object. An object has certain attributes and behavior. So as a beginner, you really don't have to understand anything about class. So I'm here just to show you how a class looks like. So this is a class with the name student. Name of the class is student, and that's the constructor. We also call it as initializer. And those are the object variables, that is roll number and name. And those are the member functions, the last, that is accept data and display data. So these are the member functions inside the class. And at the last, that's the object that we created out of the class, that is the object A. So this is the basic example of a class. Now we will see the fourth point, and the fourth point is dynamic typing. Now this particular feature is something that I personally like a lot, and that is one of the reasons that I've listed this as one of the five reasons to choose Python. So let's take an example to understand dynamic typing. So before we understand about dynamic typing in Python, we have to first understand the variables in Python. Now in Python, we do not declare a variable as what we do in other programming languages. We straight away use a variable or define a variable. For example, a is equal to 2. So the value 2 is getting assigned to a. So a is an integer variable because it's a whole number. Let's take another example. B is equal to 2.2. So the value 2.2 is getting assigned to b. So b is a floating variable. It's a float variable since there is a decimal value. And here is one more example, that is c is equal to Python. So the value Python, which is a string value, is getting assigned to C. So C is a string variable. So depends on the data type, the kind of data you're assigning to a variable, the variable will be of that particular data type. So the A is a integer variable, B is a floating variable, and C is a string variable. Now let us understand what exactly is dynamic typing. So in dynamic typing, suppose we take a variable a and we assign the value 2 to it. So it's an integer variable, and then we'll print the value. Now there is one more statement, that is a is equal to, that is a string value. Python is a wonderful language. So this is allowed in Python. The data type of a has been changed. Before it was integer, but now it is a string data type. And then we'll print the value. And if you see, there is one more statement, that is a is equal to 4.2. Now this is a floating value. Now again, the data type of a has changed. Now it's a floating variable, and then we'll print the value. If you see the output, we got 2, and then the string value, that is Python is a wonderful language, and then 4.2. So this is called as dynamic typing, where you can change the data type of a variable anytime at any point of a program. So this is a dynamic typing feature, that a was an integer variable, then it got changed to a string data type, and then it got changed to a floating data type. So that is dynamic typing. So the last point is that it is booming in industry. So let us know why. So Python is mainly used in web development, and applications like Dropbox is totally implemented in Python. Many of the Google applications are now getting implemented in Python, so it is getting huge popularity around the world. And if you talk about India, there is a huge job opportunity for you if you're good at Python, because the IT industry has now realized the power of Python. So they're looking for Python programmers. So if you're good at that, you can crack a good deal. And definitely it gets the project work done before time, and that too hassle-free. So these are some of the reasons that Python is extremely booming in industry. So let us just recollect the points. Number one, it is extremely easy to learn. Number two, codeless produce more. Number three, object-oriented language. Four, dynamic typing. And fifth, that is booming in industry. So these are the five reasons why you should be choosing Python. So before I say goodbye to you, do subscribe to my channel. There is a subscribe button in front of you. Click on that. And after that, click on the bell icon so that you can get regular notifications of my videos. And always remember one thing in your life, that impossible is nothing. Bye for now.